Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Oh, it is so good to be back in the yard together. Ashley, we haven't seen you for so long. It's so good to have you back. I think we will just jump right into it. Tradition that we kick off the season with that song. How many people remember what TV show that's from?
Cotter.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Cotter.
Mr. Cotter! All right, let me get my guitar here. I feel like there's other members of the band. This is Nick. This is Nick. This is Autumn. That's Autumn. I asked Mitch if he names his drums, and he said it's probably not good to name things you're going to hit. Fair point. I haven't asked Vince, though. Vince, you need to lean out here where people can see you a little better.
Yeah, can you wave? Wave to everyone. There we go. Hey. Do you need to?
Vince is going to think on that. He actually would like to go floating in the ocean on this particular upright bass right away, which I think would be fun to see. All right, let's keep it going. Sitting in the morning sun. Okay. Oh my gosh, it is like this temperature, this like, it just hit 7 o'clock and everything got perfect. All of you arrived and everything became perfect. All right, here's another one that's just fun to play. That I think we added this in last year. And this is a reach back to the 60s, maybe 70s, early 70s, little Sunshine Go Away. Say, I grew up listening to Jim Croce. My dad listened to it a lot, and this particular song had a swear word in it that my sisters and I were afraid to say when we were very little because we were so innocent. Jim Croce to me is so incredible. He was so incredible, God rest his soul, at painting a picture for you of these characters in everyday life. And I'm sure they were characters he met along the way as a long haul truck driver, when he was out on the road playing bars and things like that. And Lord knows Galen met a whole bunch of them when he was out touring. And so anyway, this is one of those bad, bad Leroy Brown. Trouble, and he stand about 6'4", all the time. some female singer-songwriters. Since last we were together, there's an event I do every year that I sing at. Ray Kennedy puts the program together for it, and Ray is not here with us tonight. He had some friends that needed his attention. He is exactly where he should be tonight. But Ray always picks for this particular event for A Safe Place, which is an incredible organization here in our community that helps get women and children out of human trafficking. And he always picks three female artists, singers, and then has a group of us come and sing songs from them. So last year, I can't remember who all three of them were, but one of them was Carly Simon. And so Ray said to me, I want you to cover some Carly Simon at the event. I was like, okay. And I started thinking about it, and I've never really thought about covering Carly Simon. And so I started listening to her music, and I found an amazing song called Haven't Got Time for the Pain, which the lyrics were so perfect for the event. And then I bumped into a duet between Carly and James Taylor of Mockingbird, and I was like, oh, well, that's super fun. So Shannon Playle and I did that together. And I was like, cool, that's two, I'm good. And then a few weeks before the event, Ray called and he said, well, if we're doing Carly, we really need You're So Vain. And I was like, Ray, I mean, it's You're So Vain. So here it is. Son of a gun. You walked into the party like you were walking onto a yacht. Your hat strategically dipped below one eye. Your scarf, it was Africa. afterwards wants to talk about, like, who they think it's about, you know, and all that stuff. I did, like, a big old deep dive into all of that, so it was fun. All right, we're going to stick with powerhouse female singers, little Ani DeFranco. This song, Brian, by the way, will be back this season, Brian Whitted. He is actually out on tour right now with a musical about Rick James, and I forget the name of it. Do you remember, Jean?
I can't remember my last name right now, let alone what
he's been a world traveler, so.
Sorry.
Anyway, so that's where Brian is. He is out on tour, but he will be back and join us this season as well. But this one, Little Plastic Castles, we've done it before. It's one of one we really enjoy doing. And Galen always talks about how this song, like clearly when Ani DeFranco wrote this song, it's all about being on tour and being out and going from town to town. And it's the same show and different people. And, but it all just starts to kind of seem like the same thing over and over and over again. And then I love that she also addresses, you know, with her celebrity, that she addresses what that is to have the rest of the world think they know something about you just because of what they see from the outside and they don't really know you. So anyway, I love this song, Little Plastic Castles. In a coffee shop in a city, which is every coffee shop in every city on a day, which is every day. I picked up a magazine, and I picked up a magazine.
I completely lost my place.
Jesus, so what you've done.
I started thinking about the tour and being out on the road, and I got lost in my own song. I picked up a magazine, which is every magazine. I read a story, then I forgot it right away. They say goldfish have no memories. I guess their lives are much like mine. And the little plastic castle is a surprise every time. And it's hard to say if they're happy, but they don't seem much to mind.
It's so-
actually, give it up for all the guys. Vince. Actually, you may have, so you've maybe seen Tanner back here. We've got Owen back in the back enjoying the new wall we added so people have a place to perch. We're actually recording this year. So I decided to invest a little bit in Sunday songs and in what we're doing. And the band, Brian, actually came up with a name for all of us. We are Beth Crookham and the People. These are the people. So I decided, I like it. Beth Crookham and the People. Although I said, if it's only myself and one other person, then is it Beth Crookham and the person? I don't know.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
All right. Do you guys
want to
noodle around on something?
Noodle around. I gotta switch guitars. Caitlin's gonna noodle around. Play the Bootsy song.
Yeah, we have written a Bootsy. Look at Sarah. Bootsy is the cat you see walking around here with a little big bright white boots on. Kind of the, well, she makes herself home here now. So, this is a little song I'm working on now.
She does get a lot of use out of the wall. So, all right. This is another, by the way, this is another member of the band. This is Penny. Penny is making her first Sunday Songs appearance. Someday at Sunday Songs, I'm going to give Penny to Galen, and you can hear what Penny can really do. So, this next song, this is a song, I'm so excited to be adding this to our repertoire. So this is a song that I first encountered back when I worked on One Tree Hill. And for any of you who are familiar with that show, music was a whole other character. Every episode, we were known for our music. A lot of the musicians were, let's go in a way back machine, were found through MySpace. How many of you remember MySpace? And it was this amazing platform for these like emerging artists or, you know, anyway. So one of the fun roles I got to play behind the scenes was that when bands would actually come to the show and perform on camera for us, I was the one that went to set and did all the paperwork with them and just sort of checked in with them and that sort of thing. So I got to meet everybody, and this particular group was a group called Noisettes, and their lead singer is this phenomenally cool, talented woman named Shinyi Shinawa, which is just fun to say, Shinyi Shinawa. So anyway, this is the song they did on the show. It's called Never Forget You, and it has been an earworm for me ever since, and I have always wanted to cover it, and finally, finally this winter, I guess, I said, Galen, help me, we gotta figure out how to do this. So, here it is, Never Forget You. Thank you. drinking rum or whiskey. Now won't you have a double with me? I'm sorry I'm a little late. I got your message. Charity element. I'm not quite sure what the charitable side of it was, but I think it's really cool that at least here locally the conventions now have a charitable element to them, which I think is super cool. A bunch of my old friends were back. It was fun. I actually went out and hung out in the green room for a little bit, and it was super fun to see so many of them. And Joy, actually, on June 8th, the one who played Haley, has a new movie coming out on Hallmark. So if you're a Hallmark watcher on Saturday night, there will be a new Hallmark film with Joy in it. And I think it takes place in Paris, maybe. And she's got a book coming out this fall, too. So anyway. All right. This is another one that we love to do. I'm going to keep wearing Penny, but I don't play her on this one. That's why I'll always be around. Galen-Hunsucker. And for those of you on Facebook, I actually typed it in the little description of the live, so it is there for you. All right. Oh, I have more talking to do. So this next song, we're going to close out now with three originals, so songs I've written. And this next one is actually a song that since last I saw you, I have rewritten. So I was in Iowa for a couple of months this winter, and as fate would have it, they were doing a songwriter masterclass with a guitar player songwriter named Jimmy Ryan. Does anybody know who Jimmy Ryan is? Jimmy Ryan is Carly Simon's guitar player. It all comes back around. So anyway, and oddly enough, he's originally, I think, from California and whatever, and connected with Carly out there. And he is the guitar solo that you're so familiar with on You're So Vain. That's Jimmy Ryan. And anyway, he's now settled in Iowa in his retirement. And he's touring a little bit, doing an evening with kind of thing, Jimmy Ryan. He does music from all across his decades-long career. So anyway, so I played for that masterclass my song, Love of My Life. And he had some thoughts about it, and some of the other people in attendance, there were five of us, I think, had some thoughts about it. And I decided, you know what? I think some of those thoughts are right. So I rewrote it. So some of you have never heard this song, but some of you, I look forward to seeing what you think about this rewrite, Love of My Life. One, two, three, four. much as I talk. He knows the love of my life. He thinks I'm hot. He is the love of my life. He is with big ears and a soft wet kiss. My favorite days are laying in bed. The love of my life is as good as it gets. Take it, guys. YouTube music, wherever you stream your music, it should be out there.
I gotta switch guitars. I knew that felt wrong. I know, you totally.
There's nothing I can do. She's gonna play Penny on this.
Wow. That would have been so strange. Okay, sorry about that. Thank you. 16th and the 23rd, and then we're taking a break for a little bit, but we'll be back here 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock Central, next week. See you. Have a great week and be healthy and well. cheers from across the street.